magnesium oxide. Here magnesium is oxidized into magnesium oxide. So oxidation occurs in this case. We have done till now. We know very well, when iron 3 oxide reduced, it gives iron. So it is also a reduction. In this lesson, we will study how oxidation and reduction take place together. Oxidation and reduction take place together. Look again at the reaction between copper 2 oxide and hydrogen. Copper 2 oxide loses oxygen and hydrogen gains oxygen. Here, copper 2 oxide converts into copper, so it is reduced into copper, and hydrogen is oxidized into water. So the copper 2 oxide is reduced and the hydrogen is oxidized. So we can say oxidation and reduction always take place together. So this reaction is called a redox reaction. So when both oxidation and reduction reaction occur simultaneously, this process is known as redox reaction. Let's see another example, the reaction between calcium and oxygen. Calcium burns in air with a red flame to form the white compound calcium oxide. When calcium burns with oxygen, it gives red flame of calcium oxide. It's a combustion reaction. Here, calcium is oxidized into calcium oxide. At the same time, oxygen is reduced into calcium oxide. So we can say both oxidation and reduction occurs together. The reaction between hydrogen and oxygen. Hydrogen reacts explosively with oxygen to form water. Hydrogen is oxidized and oxygen is reduced. We can see hydrogen plus oxygen converts into water. Here hydrogen is oxidized and oxygen is reduced. So we can say burning reactions are another name of burning reactions are combustion or we can say combustion is a redox reaction. For example, when an element burns in oxygen, it is oxidized to its oxide, or we can say when an element